Hello, my name is Dr. Kaydee McCray. I am of the Bitterwater people, born for the Mountain Cove people. My maternal grandparents are the Tangle people, and my paternal grandparents are the Towering House people. I am from Crown Point, New Mexico, and I am currently one of the eye doctors at Four Corners Regional Health Center. Today, we are going to talk about vision and the common causes of vision loss. We all know what vision means, but there are many aspects of vision. Two very important parts of vision are how clearly we see, that is if everything is sharp and in focus, and how good our peripheral vision is, or our side vision. Vision is important for our quality of life. Without good vision, we cannot drive a car, we cannot work to provide for our families, and we can't read or do certain jobs. And especially for our elders, they may bump into things or fall down, which could cause broken bones and other problems. We all know what the outside of the eye looks like, but let's look a little bit deeper into the structures of the eye. If we took an eyeball and cut it in half, this is what it would look like. The yellow part that's highlighted is called the cornea. Light has to go through the front window of the eye, and for light to go through, that is how we are able to see. So the yellow part highlighted on this structure is called the pupil. The pupil is formed by the green part of this structure of the eye, and this is called your iris. The iris in the general population is brown, and again, for us to see, light has to go through these two structures. The yellow part of this highlighted structure is called the lens. The lens is kind of like a lens from a pair of glasses, and it helps to focus light at the back of your eye. Again, for us to see, the light has to go through this structure. The yellow part highlighted in this structure is called the vitreous. This part of the eye is filled with a clear jelly, and again, light has to go through this structure in order for us to see. The yellow structure highlighted here is called the retina. The retina is kind of like a film in a camera, and when light hits the retina, it makes an image. The yellow part highlighted in this structure is called the optic nerve. The optic nerve is a cable that is connected from your eye all the way up to your brain. When the image is received from the retina, it is sent to the optic nerve. The optic nerve is then turns it into an electrical signal, and that signal is sent up to the brain. The brain will then tell you what you are seeing. All parts of the eye need to be healthy for us to see well. Next, we will review what happens when one of these structures has a disease. There are many reasons we can lose vision, but we'll talk now just about some of the most common causes, including refractive error, cataracts, diabetic eye disease, and glaucoma. The most common cause of vision loss is refractive error. Refractive error just means that you need eyeglasses in order to see well. This usually happens because the shape of the front part of your eye, the cornea, is not structured completely circular. It happens to people of all ages, and it's important to test our children to make sure they're seeing well in school at an early age. The photo of the sunflower on the left side is what somebody would see who has normal vision or who has their vision that has been corrected with glasses. The sunflower on the right side is somebody who sees a blurry image and does not have the proper correction for their eyesight. There are lots of types of refractive error. If you are nearsighted, you can see near but not far away. If you are farsighted, you can see far things better than you can near. And if you have astigmatism, it means that things look a little warped. They can also have a little bit of ghost imaging, and in some cases, it may be slightly double for you as well. If you have presbyopia, it means that you are older than about 45 years old and need glasses to read. The good news is that refractive error can be fixed just by getting a pair of glasses. Another common cause of vision loss that we will talk about is cataracts. Cataract is the most common cause of losing vision in older people. Cataracts affects the lens of the eye, and again, is this yellow structure highlighted in this photo. When we are born, the lens is crystal clear. In this picture, we cannot really see the lens because it's clear. But as we age, the lens starts to get cloudy, like the photo on the right. This makes it hard for the light to get through the lens, almost like you have a dirty pair of glasses. In this photo on the left with the sunflower is clear and vibrant. This is what somebody sees without cataracts. The photo on the right is something that's blurry, hazy, as well as not being as vibrant. Cataracts can cause blurry vision and make it difficult to read and difficult to drive because of glare. Almost everyone will get a cataract if they live long enough. The only way to treat a cataract is to have surgery to remove the cataract and place it with a new artificial lens. Cataract surgery is a common and safe procedure that aims to remove the cloudy lens in your eye that causes vision problems. The cataract surgery typically takes about 20 minutes and is done under local anesthesia, meaning you won't feel any pain. You do not have to stay overnight at the surgery center, and they will perform it on one eye at a time. Complications after cataract surgery are uncommon, and most can be treated successfully. Most patients see significantly better after surgery. Cataract surgery is relatively pretty simple. The basic idea is that on your visit, you will be dilated so that the surgeon has access to the lens in the back part of the brown part of your eye. The surgeon will make a tiny cut on the side of your eye and will use tiny instruments to get access to the cloudy lens. The lens will be broken up into small pieces and will be vacuumed out by those tiny instruments. Then they will add a crystal clear artificial lens that is put inside the eye. The result is that vision becomes much clearer and colors become more vibrant. Recovery is usually quick. People will often wear an eye patch for a day afterwards to protect their eye and will be given eye drops to use 2 to 4 weeks after to help the eye heal. You may be given anywhere from 2 to 3 eye drops that have different color caps. The first one is a pink cap, and that is to help reduce the inflammation in the eye. The second one is either a beige or a tan cap, and that's helped to help reduce infections in the eye. The third, which isn't given all the time, but in some cases are, is to help reduce some of the eye pain that you feel, as well as to reduce any swelling in the back part of the eye. The next common cause of vision loss we will talk about is diabetic eye disease. Diabetes happens in your eye when your blood sugar is too high. Diabetes can cause lots of problems throughout your body, including the eye. Diabetes usually affects all parts of the eye from the front to the back, causing bleeding, swelling, fluctuations in vision, as well as early cataracts. JVN is a resource that may be requested by your primary care physician on one of your visits. This resource is to take a picture of the back part of your eye and is to be assessed for any types of diabetic eye disease. This will also generate a JVN report, which will be reviewed and will give recommendations on a follow-up with your eye doctor. Depending on the level of severity of diabetes or any abnormalities, you will be reached out to in order for you to have a follow-up. This follow-up will include a dilated eye exam to further investigate. Your JVN visit should not be confused as a comprehensive eye exam. A comprehensive eye exam will be completed by your eye doctor with a dilation, and your eye will be checked all the way from the front all the way to the back. The photo on the left is a picture of the back part of your eye. This is what the eye looks like without diabetic eye disease. The photo on the right is someone with diabetic eye disease. There are small little areas of red on there, which indicates that there is leakage happening from the blood vessels. The other little parts that are in yellow mean that there is long-standing swelling occurring in the back part of the eye. Diabetic eye disease can be controlled with better control of blood sugar levels as well as medication compliance. If diabetic eye disease is caught too late, it can cause permanent damage to the eye and permanent vision loss. Everyone who is diagnosed with diabetes should get a dilated eye exam once per year. Depending on the level of your diabetic eye disease, you may require multiple follow-ups. Diabetic eye disease can cause different symptoms depending on how severe the disease is. Again, if we look to the photo on the left of the sunflower, this is what normal vision would look like without diabetes. The photo on the right is a picture of what somebody with diabetic eye disease looks like. It can cause blurry vision, it can cause dark spots, or it can cause full blackness where you cannot see at all. A lot of the time, especially for mild disease, diabetic eye disease does not require treatment if the blood glucose improves or is under control. Here are some of the ways you can prevent diabetic eye disease: having good control of blood sugar levels, taking medications as directed, maintaining a healthy diet, exercising 30 minutes 5 times a week, and getting a dilated eye exam every year. Again, depending on the severity of the eye disease, you may require multiple follow-ups. Sometimes, if the eye disease is causing problems such as vision loss or a decrease in vision, other treatments can be considered. The treatments depending on the type and severity of the eye disease, but some examples include an injection of medication into the eye, a small laser procedure on the eye, or in severe cases, surgery is required to improve the vision. These treatments will be completed at an outside facility and will require a referral. Another common cause of vision loss is glaucoma. Glaucoma is a disease of the optic nerve in the back part of the eye, and this condition typically runs in the family. An eye doctor can tell if you have glaucoma by doing a dilated eye exam and looking at your optic nerve. On the left side, you can see a healthy optic nerve that has a small indentation called a cup. This cup is generally very small in a healthy optic nerve, but with someone with glaucoma, the cup gets very big as seen on the right side, and this typically happens over the long course of many years. Often, but not always, people with glaucoma have a high pressure in their eye. The high pressure in the eye is not the same as high blood pressure. Patients with glaucoma cannot tell if their pressure is high. The only way to know is for an eye doctor to test the pressure in the eye using special equipment and doing further testing. Glaucoma is different from other causes we have discussed today, such as refractive error, cataracts, and diabetic eye disease, because it does not cause blurry vision. Instead, glaucoma reduces the peripheral vision or side vision. Early on, people usually do not notice any problems. But as glaucoma progresses with time, and people lose more and more peripheral vision over time. Importantly, vision loss from glaucoma is permanent, so it is important to catch glaucoma early and start treatment. We try to reduce the eye pressure with eye drops first. You may be put on more than one eye drop, and again, this is to help reduce the eye pressure. If eye pressure is not reduced with eye drops, this will require another referral and will include other treatments such as lasers and surgery. In summary, we have talked about different causes of vision loss. The first one we talked about is refractive error. In general, it is important to test our children to make sure they see well in school, and most causes of refractive error are correctable by wearing glasses. The second cause of vision loss that we talked about is cataract. Older people should have a dilated eye exam in order to fully assess a cataract. Simple surgery can cure a cataract. Another common cause of vision loss is diabetic eye disease. Anyone with diabetes should get an annual eye exam, and depending on the severity, are treatable with injections, lasers, and may require multiple follow-ups. Another common cause of vision loss is glaucoma. There are no symptoms early on. These typically run in the family and is treatable with eye drops and in many extreme cases, surgery and lasers. Thank you for listening to this presentation today. If you have any questions about your eye health, you can contact us at Four Corners Regional Health Center at 928-656-5020.